Dear students, welcome back to this paper 1, which is Organic Chemistry 1, Nature of Bonding and Stereochemistry. In the earlier modules, we have studied about aromaticity. In this particular module, we will be studying about another new term for you, which is homoaromaticity. When we look at the learning outcomes of this particular module, dear students, after studying this module, you will be able to understand the difference between aromaticity and homoaromaticity. You will be able to understand about the homoaromatic compounds and know the criteria for the compound to be classified as homoaromatic. And we'll also be able to know about the classification of these homoaromatic compounds. And we will discuss some examples of homoaromatic compounds, which includes cationic, neutral and anionic homoaromatics. So let us begin with this module, dear students. As you are already aware about aromaticity, which is most commonly defines the molecule to be planar and have complete delocalized system of 4n plus 2 pi electrons. And we have discussed all the conditions which are required to be fulfilled, that is cyclic, planarity, continuous delocalization and the requirement of 4n plus 2 pi electrons. And this complete cyclic delocalization of pi electrons leads to an extra thermodynamic stability and explains many of the spectroscopic, magnetic and chemical properties associated with the aromatic compounds as compared to localized resonance form. It also accounts for the reactivity of aromatic compounds, which differ significantly from alkenes, which tend to undergo addition reactions as compared to substitution reactions. Several molecules display aromatic character, but they do not strictly follow the definition which we have discussed just now and in the earlier modules. And this leads to extension of the definition of aromaticity. For example, Möbius aromatics have 4n pi electrons and yet they exhibit aromatic character. Spherically aromatic structures such as C60 are aromatic in spite of being non-planar. Cyclopropane displays aromaticity in sigma orbitals rather than pi orbitals, and inorganic pi complexes such as ferrocene, they exhibit aromaticity in 3 dimensions. Similarly, homoaromatic compounds also exhibit aromatic behavior, but in different manner, which we will discuss in this module. So let us begin with knowing homoaromaticity in more detail. So as in the previous module, we discussed about the compounds which contain alternate, double and single bond, cyclic, planar and following the Huckel's rule are aromatic. But in 1959, Saul Winstein talked about a new class of aromatic molecules during his study of tris homocyclopropanoyl cation. Now these molecules were termed as homoaromatic molecules, which showed discontinuity in the p orbital overlap due to the presence of a single sp3 hybridized atom, which is generally a CH2 group, but larger alkyl residue or a heteroatom and one or several positions within the ring could also be present. So we can say that those compounds where the stable configuration system with 4n plus 2 pi electrons can only be formed by bypassing one saturated sp3 hybridized carbon atom leads to homoaromaticity. And such compounds are definitely less stable than the aromatic compounds, because aromatic compounds are having complete delocalization of pi electrons, but in these cases they show poor overlap of the p orbitals. Let us consider some examples. First of all, let us consider this homotropylium ion, which is cyclooctatrienyl cation, as you can see here. Now this is formed when cyclooctatetraene is treated with sulfuric acid. As a result, you can see this carbocation is generated, and then there will be delocalization, and you can see that this CH2 actually comes out of the plane and rest is all planar, and there is a continuous delocalization of pi electrons happening, and the 6 pi electrons here which are delocalizing can be assumed to be delocalized over 7 carbon atoms. And the 8th carbon atom, which is the saturated one, undergoes non-planary, that is the 7 carbons are here and the one will be above the plane, and the 6 pi electrons are having continuous delocalization over these 7 carbon atoms. Now these homoaromatic compounds are generally, they exist either as cationic or anionic species, but some studies also gives the evidence of the existence of some neutral homoaromatic molecules, although these are very less common. The homotropylium cation, which is C8H9+, is perhaps the best studied example of a homoaromatic compound. As you can see here in this particular diagram shown here, that you can see there is a continuous delocalization of these 6 pi electrons, and you will be having the aromaticity because of this continuous delocalization, and the CH2 is out of the plane. Let us now talk about the evidence of homoaromaticity. Winston proposed the first homoaromatic compound, that is tris homocyclopropionyl cation, which is, you can see the structure here, and this evidence is collected from the acetolysis experiment of the structure 1, in which its cis epimer reacts 35 times faster than the trans epimer. Evidences for homoaromatic structure was acquired from deuterium scrambling, and it was found that 66% of deuterium was found on cyclopropane ring at position 1 and 5 and only 33% on the carbonyl carbon, that is at the position 3. Now this suggests that all the 3 positions 1, 3 and 5 were equivalent, and the structure 3, as you can see here, later on is called as homoaromatic, and you can see the justification why this is referred to as homoaromatic, because of the delocalization, and this will be showing the aromatic property, but then it does not fall into the straightaway criteria of aromatic species that we have discussed earlier. Now after this discovery, many cationic, neutral and anionic compounds have been suggested to show homoaromaticity. Now these compounds attain stability due to the homoconjugation. Homoconjugation, or in other words homoconjugative interactions, account for the complete cyclic delocalization of foreign electrons and then lowering the energy. But there are some other conditions which are responsible for the characteristic aromatic properties of these compounds. Let us know all these criteria. So in the criteria for homoaromaticity, what all we have to look at in the structure, these are as follows. To explain the characteristic aromatic properties of such compounds, we should first learn some of the conditions for the molecule to show homoaromaticity, and these are: number one, the molecules should possess one or more homoconjugative interactions, either through bond or through space, closing the cyclic conjugation. The second condition required is a closed cyclic system must show electron delocalization through either effective overlap between the pi orbitals of the cyclic system, or bond orders and pi characteristic indices should be close to that of an aromatic pi system. Further, positive or negative charge should be delocalized throughout the cyclic system in case of charged molecules, It should not be just localized at one particular position. Further on, there should be large degree of bond equalization resulting in difference of bond lengths from those of the normal single or double bond. The third point is, for either cyclopropyl or no bond homoaromatic systems, the number of pi electrons participating in cyclic electron delocalization should be close to 4n plus 2. The fourth condition or the criteria that you can look for is homoaromaticity should have resonance energy greater than 2 kilocalories per mole, which leads to stabilization. And the fifth condition is no bond homoaromatic systems should possess exceptional magnetic properties that should lead to either significant equalization of 13C chemical shifts in the cyclic system or the magnetic susceptibility adopting a maximum value for an unconstrained homoaromatic system indicating homoaromatic electron delocalization, or a large chemical shift difference between endo and exo oriented protons when the molecule possesses a CH2 group properly located above the ring. So you have to keep all these conditions in mind, and that's how you can come to know whether this molecule will be homoaromatic or not. Now, after knowing these conditions, let us understand how these homoaromatic compounds are classified. Homoaromatic compounds, they get stabilized due to some interactions which result in delocalization that we have understood. So therefore, depending upon the type of interactions, homoaromatics are classified into different categories. And these categories, let us study one by one. First of all, no bond homoaromatic. And these are the compounds where the cyclic delocalization is achieved through space and not through any bond. Then we have sigma bond homoaromatics. Now, these are the compounds, these are the homoaromatic compounds where the cyclic delocalization is achieved through the bond interaction, which are sigma bond, as the name clearly tells. And then we come to the homoaromatics having transannular homoconjugative interactions, and it perturbs the aromatic delocalization. For example, the bridged anilines 15C1 to C6, which is called as homonaphthalene, and 16C1 to C5, which is homoaniline, due to the transannular homoconjugation. Further, no bond and bond homoaromatics, they are related by rearrangement, as you can see in this figure that there is a valence tautomerism between 1,3,5-cycloheptatriene and non-cardene. So you can see these structures here, and these are related by rearrangement. By doing this rearrangement, you get this structure, and this is how the delocalization can be easily explained. Both of them are well set up for homoconjugation, you can see in these structures. And in Winston's terminology, they are referred as monohomoaromatic and termed as monohomobenzene, as there is only one interruption to the direct aromatic conjugation of benzene. Just compare these structures with benzene, you will understand why this is called so. So, multiple homoconjugative insertions into an aromatic may result in bis, tris and tetra homoaromatics and so on. So, I think you are now clear about the classification. Now, let us work out on some examples to understand the homoaromaticity much more clearly. So, let us first look at the cationic homoaromatics. As the name tells you, the cationic homoaromatic compounds will bear a positive charge in them, and they are most studied species for homoaromaticity. First example that we can consider here is the homotropinylium ion, and many homoaromatic cationic compounds generally use a cyclopropenyl cation or ट्रोपीलियम केटायन और ए साइक्लोब्यूटाडाइन डाइकेटायन एज देयर बेस एंड सिंस दीज कंपाउंड्स एग्जिबिट स्ट्रॉन्ग एरोमेटिक करेक्टर सो यू टेक देम एज बेस एंड देन यू गेट दीज वेरियस होमो एरोमेटिक स्पीशीज एंड यू कैन क्लियरली सी द साइक्लोप्रोपीनाइल केटायन और द ट्रोपीलियल केटायन एंड द साइक्लोब्यूटाडाइन डाइकेटायन दे आर will be showing the aromatic behavior and they come into this category. Another well-established homoaromatic cation which shows strong homoaromaticity is non-bornine 7-aryl cation. As you can look at this structure and this also will be showing aromaticity. An interesting example of pegodanes which in dicationic form show sigma bis homoaromaticity is termed as 2-electron sigma bis homoaromatic system. In these 4-centered 2-electron systems, the delocalizations happen in the plane that is defined by the 4-carbon atoms like the sigma aromaticity which is shown in cyclopropane. And this gains about 11.3 kilocalories per mole stability from the effect. The dications are formed either via oxidation of pegadane or via oxidation of the corresponding bis seco dodecahedradiene, as you can see in this structure. But the reduction of the corresponding 6-electron dianions was not possible so far. After the cationic homoaromatic compounds, let us now discuss the neutral homoaromatic compounds. Some studies also account for the less commonly available neutral homoaromatic compounds. As the name tells, they bear no positive or negative charge. And there are many classes which include in neutral homoaromatic compounds, which we will discuss one by one. First of them is monohomoaromatics. Many examples of monohomoaromatics were studied, such as cycloheptatriene and dihydro 1,2,4,5 tetrazine, and you can look at these structures A and B shown here. However, with the new modern experimental and theoretical methods, these have now been classified as only marginally homoaromatic. And these are the structures that you can see. Further, fullerides, as you can look at the structure 3, display transannular homoaromaticity and therefore they are also monohomoaromatic. Another example, 60-carbon fulleride derivative, which has a single methylene bridge, shows homoaromaticity. The homoaromatic fullerenes were synthesized by dipolar cycloaddition at the 6-6 ring junction with a diazomethane to form the structure 2, followed by nitrogen extrusion at high temperature, which further rearranges to form the homoaromatic compound that is the structure 3, as you can see here. So this is how the formation of C60 fulleride is taking place, which is monohomoaromatic. The UV spectrum of this structure 3 was found to be identical to that of C60 itself, indicating no interruption in aromaticity. The next category we have is bis homoaromaticity. The bis homoaromatics is another class of compounds that exhibit neutral homoaromaticity, and they are beryline and semibulvaline. Semibulvaline, they are synthesized by photochemical isomerization of beryline. Now these are bis homoaromatics, which are defined as those species which contain 2 saturated sp3 centers, that is having methylene, and they interfere with the pi electron system. Semibulvaline has a structure that accounts well to homoaromaticity, though there have been questions raised to the fact that whether semi-vulvalin derivatives can be truly delocalized ground state neutral homoaromatic compound or not. But strategic addition of cyclic annulation introduces ring strain into the molecule aimed at destabilizing the localized ground state structures, and a delocalized homoaromatic ground state structure can be achieved. So you can see how from beryllium you can get the semi-vulvalin which will be homoaromatic. Next compound we will like to mention here is 1,2-diboritane. So this another compound known to exhibit neutral homoaromaticity containing boron, and it is 1,2-diboritane and its derivatives. Substituted diboritanes, they show strong homoaromaticity due to the greater stabilization in the delocalized state over the localized one. A classical structure with localized bonds is favored when electron donating groups are attached to the two boron atoms, whereas with electron withdrawing groups it adopts a non-classical delocalized structure and homoaromatic character is then best seen. So you can relate well with these structures where these groups are the electron donor or respectively electron acceptors as shown here, and that's how it will be bringing the homoaromatic character. The next category we will like to mention is the tris homoaromatics. Tris means now three, so there will be three methylene bridge. So the class of tris homoaromatics, they are defined as those systems which contain one more additional methylene bridge as compared to bis homoaromatics, and you can say two more additional bridge as compared to mono homoaromatics. They have homoaromatic stabilization through the interaction of three double bonds, and they gain stabilization from delocalization, and that is only 5% to that of benzene. And some examples you can see as they are shown here. So you can see all of them, they are having these three methylene bridge, and these are the tris homoaromatic compounds. After this, let us now understand the category of anionic homoaromatics. Like the cationic homoaromatics, anionic homoaromatics have also been accepted to exhibit true homoaromaticity, and obviously they will be possessing a negative charge. These anionic homoaromatics are often prepared from their neutral parent compounds through reduction with lithium metal. Recently, 1,2-diboritanide and dianionic bisdiazine have been established, and let us look at their structures one by one. So first of all, about this 1,2-diboritanide, this molecule, it was prepared by the reduction of their neutral analogs with lithium metal, and 1,2-diboritanide and their derivatives, they show strong homoaromaticity through their three atom, that is boron, boron and carbon, and two electron bond. Now it contains CB bonds which are shorter than their neutral classical analog, and these can also expand to larger ring sizes with different substituents, and all contain some degree of homoaromaticity. So you can see the structure clearly here, and how this will be showing, this anion will be showing the homoaromaticity. Let us take the next example, which is bisdiazine class under the anionic homoaromaticity. So this anionic homoaromaticity can also be seen in dianionic bisdiazine compounds which contain a 4 atom, that is nitrogen, and also 6 electron center, and it is also termed as 4 center 6 electron sigma bis homoaromaticity. The compound is known to show the shortening of the transannular nitrogen distance, indicating that the dianionic bisdiazine is a type of anionic bis homoaromatic compound. In these systems, the cyclic electron delocalization takes place in the sigma plane formed by the four nitrogen atoms, as you can see in their structures. So clearly, these four nitrogen atoms, through them there will be a cyclic delocalization, and that is how it will be exhibiting the homoaromaticity. With the increasingly extensive exploration of novel compounds showing the properties similar to those having aromatic character, it is difficult to devise a simple definition of aromaticity, and for this reason it is also hard to constrain the aromaticity in any single criterion of characterization. Therefore, potential aromatic compounds are evaluated by energetic, geometric and magnetic criteria. So I am very sure now you are able to understand the aromaticity concept that we have learnt in earlier modules, and how homoaromaticity is different than aromaticity. Also, although homoaromaticity is also leading to the stability of the molecule, that is the aromaticity in lowering the thermodynamic energy and providing the stability to the molecule. So with this, let us now summarize what we have learnt in this module. We have studied that a homoaromatic molecule, it showed discontinuity in the p orbital overlap due to the presence of a single sp3 hybridized atom, mostly a methylene group. So that we can say that these compounds where the stable configuration system are having 4n plus 2 pi electrons, but that is being obtained by bypassing one of the saturated sp3 hybridized carbon, and that leads to homoaromaticity. The homotropylene cation is the best studied example of homoaromatic compound, and we studied that in detail. We also discussed the various criteria which are required to be fulfilled by a compound to be classified as homoaromatic, and let us recall those. That is, the molecule should possess one or more homoconjugative interactions. It should be a closed cyclic system which shows electron delocalization. The number of pi electrons participating in the cyclic electron delocalization should be close to 4n plus 2. No bond homoaromatic systems should possess exceptional magnetic properties. Homoaromaticity should have resonance energy greater than 2 kilocalories per mole, which leads to stabilization. And we also studied about the various classification of homoaromatic compounds depending upon the type of interactions, and also we classified and understood some examples of cationic, neutral and anionic homoaromatic compounds.